Atlantic Ave has always been Delray's main street. In the early 20th century, nearly a dozen different resort hotels lined its path to the beach. One of them was the famed Colony Hotel.
This building is the only hotel that is left.
So it's a real link to the past.
It is, in a way, and a lot of people really like it that way.
Justina Boughton does. Her mother and father bought this hotel in the 1930s. It was a time when their guests spent a winter vacation here and a summer one at the family's still-thriving Kennebunkport, Maine hotel.
I've tried to keep a lot of things, although everything was painted beige.
While Boughton had everything repainted with properly tropical palette, she did keep many original touches from the wicker to, well.
All right, granted, the original switchboard here no longer works, but remember phone booths? Still works.
Oh, looking for the elevator?
This is a relic. I love it.
Being a historic hotel, it's fun to hold on to the past, like this elevator,
right,
but also be able to offer modern things such as TV,
yes,
Wi-Fi.
Truthfully, the rooms are just that blend, and the Colony also offers guests its own private club at the beach. But about all that history, has to be a ghost story here, right?
So this is your grandfather.
Somebody swears they saw him walking across the dining room, through the wall, into the kitchen. So I think
without using the door.
Yes, yeah, no, yeah, through the wall.
The iconic hotel remains perhaps the most painted and photographed landmark in Delray Beach. You only have to look as far as the Lois Brzezinski Gallery just outside the hotel.
The dome and the flags and the archways. There's just so many different elements from an artistic point of view that make that building very interesting.
We last visited with acclaimed painter Lois Brzezinski in the Cayman Islands. Today, she lives and paints in Delray Beach.
A friend of mine lived in Boca Raton and had been urging me to come to Florida, and I said, no, Florida's not my kind of place. But we came to Delray Beach for lunch, and immediately I felt at home. I saw a guy carrying a surfboard up the street, a pretty little street scene, a place that looked like a village.
What has drawn your eye as an artist here?
I love the architecture. I love the textures, the colors, the arches. There's a distinctive light to the tropics. The way light hits buildings and foliage, that just is magical.
Even when it's in your own backyard.
As soon as the color hits the paper and it starts to spread, and I put my brush in another color, and still a wonderful part of my life, yeah.
Truth is, Delray Beach has long been a haven for artists of all kinds, and it retains an unusually vibrant and inviting art scene today.
What do you think that is?
Maybe it was the architecture. You know, artists are drawn to things that are a little off the grid.
And Delray was that.
And I think Delray was that, yeah.
You see it everywhere, on the streets themselves, not to mention the street signs, in the city's commitment to performance spaces, from the new live music venue on the ground floor of a parking garage to the venerable Delray Beach Playhouse, where top billing is shared with its stunning location on Lake Ida. The city's newest venture for the arts may be its most ambitious. After all, it fills an entire warehouse.
What drew you here?
Look at the space. It's wonderful. It's a beautiful place to work.
Sculptor Sherry Salibi is an artist in residence at Arts Warehouse. Located in Delray's Pineapple Grove Arts District, the 15,000 square foot former warehouse opened just this past fall under the city's Community Redevelopment Agency. The goal is to create an arts incubator, place for artists of various media to work near each other and to learn business skills to aid them in furthering their careers commercially.
They're in a place where they have a subsidized rent program that allows them to be able to spend time developing bodies of work, a little bit more time reaching out to gallery owners and museums and start writing grants.
Photographer and Delray Beach native Angie Myers moved back here to be part of this new project.
This is where I grew up and where I wanted to ground myself.
Do you like the idea of being surrounded by other artists?
Absolutely. I feed off their energy. It inspires you to go the next level and see what you can do too.
There's a ground floor exhibit space, and the building is open to the public. For the artists themselves, there is most of all a sense of creating a new chapter in this city's long embrace of the arts.
I think that the arts made Delray what it is. You put artists anywhere, and it's going to make a difference.
And like so many people in the Delray area, artist Lois Brzezinski has a connection to New England. She actually is a graduate of the Rhode Island School of Design.
And the Colony Hotel, back to that and its owner, really one of the largest and longest supporters of the arts in Delray. And you can see why, because it's so popular as a subject for artists as well.
Beautiful. There's a reason it's called Boston's on the Beach.
Are these really, really small championship banners or really large cocktail napkins?